Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with client server architecture, so let's start. So it is very easy and I'll be just explaining in short and not in detail, so let's start. So all e-commerce application follow client server model. Why? So because it is very efficient, very easy to implement, and it is very useful also. So what are clients over here? Clients are the devices plus software that requests information from server. So clients are nothing, just the device, okay? And these devices are used by the users, or you can say the consumer or the customers, okay? So here is the short diagram of the client server architecture. Here you can see the application logic or application layer, then presentation logic or presentation layer, both on the client side as well as on the server side. So what it happens is, if clients want some kind of work to be done from the server, right? So what they do is they process a request to the server, and if authentic, if it is right, if it is okay, then the server gives the result to the client, okay? So this is how client server architecture works, okay? This is a basic diagram, okay? So it links PCs to a storage or database server where most of the computing is done on the client side. Why computing is done on the client side? Why? So because they don't want to pressurize the server, okay? Because server will be serving many clients or many customers at a time, right? So if the load will be on the server time, then server will get hanged, right? So that's why most of the load is kept on the client side. And clients are allowed to interact with the server through a request reply sequence by using message passing system. So you can see that clients communicate with the server with the help of a message passing system if they want any request to be completed with the server, okay? So server manages any application tasks that the clients wants to get done, or handle storage, like they're handling the client storage in that, and also verifying the security, right? Security is also important, right? So that is also done on the server side, not on the client side, because client will be anonymous, right? And what is kept on the client side? The user interface. Like if client is requesting to the server, then client side will be having some kind of web browser or some kind of application through which it is communicating, right? So that will be the user interface for communicating with the server. So this was all about the client server architecture in short. I hope the basic idea about client server architecture you must have got. So if you got, then do hit the like button, do be subscribing, and thanks for watching.